Hi children, today in this video you are going to study division by 10, 100 and 1000. That will be the concluding part of this chapter. Now you can see the example over here, 31.5 divided by 10. Either you divide like this as the traditional form, 315 divided by 10, because here you have one decimal place, so we are putting 10 in the denominator place by removing the decimal point, divided by 10 upon 1, and next step, division becomes multiplication, and as per the rule, we take the reciprocal of the divisor. So 10 by 1 becomes 1 upon 10. Now you have final answer 315 divided by 100. So what do you get? Two zeros in the denominator place. So where will you put the decimal point? From right hand side, count two digit and put decimal point. This is one way of answering. Same way, you can carry on the division by 100. 315 divided by 10 multiplied by 1 upon 100 gives you 315 divided by 10, 100 is 1000. So three zeros, so three decimal places after decimal point, 1, 2, 3 and put the point, so 0.315, and like that you can carry on the division by 1000. This is one way of doing it. The other thing you can do directly in one step is, when you are dividing by 10, you have 1 0 and the decimal point will shift one digit towards left hand side. You did not carry out the whole calculation like this. In one step you can do it. If you are dividing by 10, as you have 1 0, the point will move towards the left hand side or shift one digit towards the left hand side, and your answer will be 3.15. when you are dividing with 100, it will move two digits towards left hand side, 1 2, and the point you put, so 0.315. and same thing you can do it, you will get, if you divide it with 1000, what will happen? It will move three digits towards left hand side, so 1 2 3, there is nothing over here, so you will put 0. The decimal point will shift 1 2 3, three digits, and then you will put the point, and your final answer will be 0.0315. this decimal point will shift three digits towards left hand side and you get this answer. So directly you can do the division by 10, 100 and 1000. So we can say that while dividing a number by 10, 100 or 1000, the digits of the number and the quotient are same, but the decimal point in the quotient shifts towards the left by as many places as there are zeros over 1. You can see here you have 1 0, the dividend and the quotient both are same, the figures are same, only the decimal point shifts 1 0, so the point will move one digit towards left hand side, two zeros, so it will move or shift two digits towards the left hand side, three zeros, so it will move three digits towards the left hand side. Is that clear to you? So we move on to the exercise. Here you can see exercise 2.7, question number 1, find the answer. 0.4 divided by 2. 4 upon 10 divided by 2 upon 1. 4 by 10 multiplied by 1 upon 2 as per the rule. And so 2's are 4, and so 2 upon 10, that is 0.2, will be the answer. Sum number 2, 0.35 divided by 5, same way you carry on the division, and so answer is here 5 7's are 35, so 7 is left, 7 1's are 7 and 100 1's are 100. 7 upon 100 gives you 0.07. why? Because there are two zeros and two digits should be there after decimal point, that is two decimal places should be there. So divide by 4, like this you do it. Otherwise you can divide, carry on the division. 248 divided by 4, you get 62. 62 is the answer. And how many decimal places are here? There is no decimal place over here. Here you have only 2. So in the answer you have 2 decimal places, 0.62. Yeah. So here both the ways I have done, but the final answer will be like this. Okay. You can see when I am dividing, division goes on, and where will I put the decimal point? Here the point is there in the question. And so when the division goes on, 6 ones are 6. 6 minus 6 is 0, bring down 5. 5 is smaller than 6, so I will put 0, and then you will bring down the second next number. Before you bring down the next number, what I have to put, I will put a decimal point over here. Why? Because here we have decimal point. Before we move on to 4, we have to put point, as point is over here. And now you bring down 4, 54 or 5.4 it is. So 6 9's are 54 or 5.4. So your answer is 10.9. Same thing was done over here. You can see in the question the decimal point is here. So I cannot carry, because before point you have 2. 2 is smaller than 4. So before I carry out the division, I have to put 0 and put point. Right? And then you go for the next digit, 4. 2.4. Now 24 is divisible by 4. If you ignore this point, the number is 24. So 6, 4, 6 are 24. Now bring down 8, 4, 2 is 8. So you got the answer 0.62. Understood how we get the answer if we carry out the division directly? Here you can see it. Here I did it in the way in which the book is given. And this is direct division. Only you have to keep in mind the decimal point when you put the quotient. Okay, 6 ones are 6 as I have explained you. And same thing you can see here, 651.2. First digit 6 is greater than 4. 4 ones are 4. 6 minus 4 is 2, bring down 5. You have 25. 4 6 are 24. Subtract it, you get 1. Bring down 1, 11. Again it is divisible. 4 2s are 8. On subtracting we get 3. Now before we bring down 2, we have a decimal point. So you put point over here. Now you bring down 2, you have 32, or you can say 3.2. For division you ignore the 2 point over here. 4 8s are 32. So now you get 0 in the remainder place, and you have 162.8 is the answer. Likewise you will carry out the division of 6 7 8 sum of question number 1. It's a self practice. Move on to the question number 2. Find the division where you are dividing the number by 10. have explained you with the help of example. Here you can see self practice, you do it. Same question number 3, divide the given numbers by 100. We can take help of the example, and here division carried out by 1000. We can have a look at it. So are the sums done over here? 4 and 5, we have to do self practice, and you can see I have solved the sum for you. And now comes dividing a whole number with an integer or a decimal number. Okay, question number 5, find 7 divided by 3.5. Here you can see 36 divided by 0.2. Here you can see 3.25 divided by 0.5. How will you do the division? Now see, 7 by 1 divided by 35 by 10. Multiplication, convert division to multiplication and take the reciprocal of 35 by 10, 10 by 35. Simplify it, 5 2s are 10, 5 7s are 35. This 7 and this 7 gets cancelled and the answer left is 2. Same, you can divide this way or the method I have showed in the previous question. You can carry out the division in whichever way you want to. Okay, see here now, both the numbers are decimal numbers. You can divide like this or you carry out the division. 325 divided by 5, you got 65. Now in this case, what you have to do, you have to subtract the decimal places. Here you have 2 decimal place and you have 1 decimal place. 2 minus 1 is 1, so your answer will be having 1 decimal place. So the point will be put counting 1 digit from behind and put the decimal. Is that clear to you? Carry out the division as you carry out as you divide simple numbers, and then subtract the decimal places. 2 decimal place and 1 decimal place over here. 2 minus 1 gives you 1, and your final answer will be having 1 decimal place. Same thing you can see here. Both the methods I have showed, divide it, 2 decimal place 1, 2 minus 1 is 1, so your answer will be having 44.2, and here you can see your answer will be 44.2. Carefully look at this, how I have done it. You will understand now, hope you will understand clearly. So, and the last one. Question number 6, a vehicle covers a distance of 43.2 km in 2.4 liters of petrol. How much distance will it cover in 1 liter of petrol? So we have two parts, kilometer and liters. Very simple, 43.2 km and it consumes 2.4 liters, so 2.4 liters have written. We have to find out the distance covered in 1 liter. So under the liter section you put 1 and under kilometer put a question mark. Cross multiplication, 43.2 multiplied by 1 divided by 2.4. So distance covered by vehicle in 1 liter petrol. Carry out the division. And this way you can do, or you do it this way. And on the same, and the answer which you get is 18 kilometer. This 10 and 10 gets cancelled. 432 divided by 24 gives you 18 kilometer. That's the end of chapter 2, and our next video is going to be of chapter 3, data handling. Till then, goodbye.